Hello students, today we are going to learn about the format for determining the assessable value of goods. So here the importer, the one who import the goods from other country, has to pay the custom duty. So this custom duty is a tax which is levied on the value of a imported goods. So the custom duty is levied on the value of a imported goods. So this value of imported goods is nothing but the assessable value of goods. So in today's class we are going to learn about how to compute the value of goods for custom duty calculation purpose. So now see the format. So this we have to draw three column, particulars and two amount column. So this format, calculation of assessable value of goods, starts with the purchase price of a goods. So the purchase price of goods is nothing but it is a price when importer import a goods. So what is the price of a goods imported? So that is the purchase price of that goods. So for this purchase price, we have to add the sum of the expenses. So when you add the expenses, you will get free on board value of goods. After that, again we have to add some of the expenses. So after adding that, you will get the CIF, cost, insurance, freight or assessable value of a goods. So here there are two part of expenses we have to add. There are two part of additions here. So the first part is expenses which is incurred by the exporter. So this is a part of expenses which is incurred by the exporter. Okay, so now we'll see how this expenses will be incurred by the exporter. So here when a importer import a goods from other country, so we'll take the exporter place. So he is a importer importing a goods from a country. Exporter place, maybe it is USA or Japan, any country. So exporter place, so there it is, a exporter place. So we'll take the importer place as a India. Importer place as a India. So from when a importer imports any goods from a USA or a Japan, so that is a exporter place. So directly he can't sell the goods to the importer place, so the exporter has to incur some of the expenses. So from a exporter place, maybe from a exporter's godown or his factory, from a godown or a factory, he has to carry the goods to the airport or maybe ship port. So if he is transporting the goods through the aeroplane, then he has to carry that goods to airport. If he is transporting or selling the goods through ship, then he has to carry that goods through ship port. So from exporter's factory to airport or a ship port, so there will be some of the expenses incurred, maybe the transportation charges, loading charges from factory to airport, maybe loading here, loading the goods, and again here in the airport unloading the goods, or freight charges or any other expenses. There will be expenses incurred here. So there are some expenses which will be incurred from a exporter's factory or a godown to the airport. Again, the same goods here it will be unloaded, and through an aeroplane or a ship it will be transported to the, this is the exporter airport. So it is transported through a flight or through a ship, transported to the, again if it is through aeroplane, then it is transported to airport of a importer place, airport or maybe ship port. So from exporter's airport to the importer airport, or from exporter's ship port, if it is transportation is by ship, from a exporter ship port to importer ship port. So again, for this transportation there might be expenses incurred here. Maybe the aeroplane charges, or maybe the ship charges, transportation charges, like. So here also the expenses will be incurred. So here again, when the goods is reaches to the airport or ship port, so the importer has to carry that goods to the importer's place or his importer's godown or importer's factory. He has to carry the goods to importer's place. So again here there might be a transportation expenses. So there may be a many expenses will be incurred here also. So there are three part. So when a importer import any goods from other countries, maybe USA or Japan, so in three stages the expenses will be incurred. So the first one is from an exporter's place or a godown or a factory, from his place to the airport or ship port, the expenses will be incurred for to carry the goods to here. Again, from the exporter's airport or a ship port to the importer airport or a ship port, it is a USA or a Japan port, USA or Japan port. If you take it as an importer, then it is an Indian airport or a ship port. So from here, so again there will be expenses incurred in the second stage, and again the third stage, airport to Indian airport to the importer place. So in three kinds of places the expenses will be incurred when an importer import a goods. So here the importer has to pay the custom duty when goods delivers here. So if he want to when an importer import a goods, so in the airport or a ship port he has to pay the custom duty. So this importer from India, importer from India, the one who want to purchase from outside, he has to pay the custom duty here in the airport or a ship port for the import of his goods. So while paying a custom duty, we have to add, while paying a, when a importer pay a custom duty, so he has to calculate what is the value of goods. So here he is paying a custom duty here. So here value of goods we have to take. For the value of goods, we have to include only the expenses which is incurs from a exporter place to exporter port, from a exporter port to the, from a exporter port to the Indian airport, only till. So the expenses which is incurred in between here is included for computation of assessable value. Understood? So whatever the expenses incurs after reaching the goods to the Indian airport, from an Indian airport, whatever the expenses incurs to carry that goods to the importer place, it is not taken for calculating the assessable value of a goods. Understood? It is not included to calculate the assessable value of goods. So remember, for the purchase price of goods, we have to add the sum of the expenses. So this is the expenses we have to add which is incurred by the exporter. So that is the expenses we have to add, the expenses which is incurred here from exporter place to the exporter port. Whatever the expenses included should be added before FOB. So remember this word, should be added before FOB. So this is the FOB. Before FOB means here we have to add. Okay, for this purchase price of goods, we have to add some of the expenses. So these are the expenses which is incurred in between of this gap. So that is from exporter place, from exporter factory to the exporter port. So whatever the expenses incurs here should be added before FOB. Then from here, from an exporter port to the Indian port, so the whatever the expenses incur, so it is from port to port, means maybe the ship charges or maybe air charges, flight charges, like that expenses will be there. So that will be added after FOB. So remember, so these expenses should be added after FOB. So it should be added after FOB, and these expenses should be added before FOB, should be added before FOB. So the expenses which is incurred by the exporter from an exporter place to the exporter airport, so it should be added before FOB, means it should be added before FOB. Or and any expenses incurred from an airport exporter's port to the Indian's importer port, so that expenses should be added after FOB. So that is, we have to add after FOB. So the normally the through air or through ship there will be expenses incurred, only that expenses we have to add here. So after that, after the import from a Indian port, whatever the expenses incurs to carry that goods to the importer place, it should not be added to compute the assessable value, because we are calculating the assessable value to calculate the taxes, to calculate the custom duty. So this custom duty is paid here. So the expenses what is incurred after paying the custom duty is not included for the assessable value. So that is a point you have to remember. So when an importer imports goods from any of a country outside India, he has to pay the custom duty here. So to pay the custom duty, we need to calculate the assessable value of goods. So this assessable value of goods should be calculated by adding the expenses which is incurred from an exporter place to the Indian port. Clear? So now we'll see this format for determining the assessable value of goods. So here, so this format starts with the purchase price of a goods. So the purchase price means when the exporter manufacturer goods, so there will be a price he will be fixing for the goods. So that is the price for that goods. The whatever the importer purchase a goods from an exporter, so what is the price of that goods should be taken first, purchase price of a goods. Next we have to add the expenses. So which is the expenses which is incurred by a exporter, only we have to add before FOB. Okay, so before FOB we have to add the expenses which is incurred by the exporter, so that is from a exporter place to the exporter port. So see one by one. First one is commission or a brokerage to a local agent except buying commission. So commission or a brokerage paid to a local agent. Local agent means it is a exporter agent. So here the exporter have to appoint an agent in India in order to promote his sale in India. So that is the exporter's expenses. Commission which is paid to a local agent. So this local agent is nothing but he is a exporter's agent staying in India. He is a exporter's agent staying in India. So he stays in India to help the exporter to promote his sales in India. So he is a local agent. So on behalf of a exporter, so for this commission will be paid. So here we have to add a commission or a brokerage paid to a local agent. So this commission will be paid by the importer on behalf of a exporter. Okay, so this commission will be paid by a importer on behalf of a exporter. So local agent is nothing but he is a exporter's agent who is staying in India. Local means he is staying in India. He is an exporter's agent staying in India and he helps the exporter to promote his sales in India. So he is an exporter agent. He will be staying in India and he will help the exporter to increase to promote his sales in India. So for that, the importer has to pay a commission to the local agent. So this commission will be paid to the exporter's agent on behalf of a exporter. So on behalf of a exporter, importer will pay the commission to his agent who is staying in India. So that is the expenses. So that is the expenses should be paid by the exporter on behalf of a exporter. Importer will be paying. So that expenses we have to add here. A commission or a brokerage which is paid to a local agent is nothing but exporter agent we have to add, because it is taken as a exporter's expenses. We have to take the exporter's expenses. And except buying commission means, buying commission is nothing but it is a importer's agent commission. So importer agent may be staying outside India. Importer agent may be staying outside India. That importer agent will help the importer to import any goods from outside country. From outside country. So to import any goods from outside country, for this importer there will be a agent here. So that agent is called as a buying agent or a importer agent. So whatever the commission paid by a importer to the his own agent is nothing but it is the importer expenses, it is not exporter's expenses. So buying commission we should not include for the exporter's expenses. So only the commission which is paid to local agent should be taken. So local agent means the agent will be staying in India and on behalf of an exporter he will be promoting the sales in India. So for that purpose the one who import has to pay a commission on behalf of an exporter. So that is a one of an exporter's expenses should be added here. Commission or brokerage paid to a local agent we have to take, but buying commission we should not take. Then any expenses in connection with the goods, maybe the cost of packing. For the packing of goods there might be expenses incurred, or any cost of molds. Molds also similar to packing. Then any cost of container, these are the similar to packing for the, these are the expenses which is incurs for the packing for the goods should be added. Because packing and all will be incurs here, packing expenses and all incurs here, so we should add. But cost of a returnable container we should not take. Okay, only the cost of container we have to take. Cost of returnable container is not a part of assessable value. Then cost of technical know-how. Technical know-how means to manufacture a product here, there might be a some of the ideas they have to get. So that is nothing but technical know-how. Any expenses incurred in relating to it, so it is should be added here. Then any accessories or materials supplied along with the machine by the importer to the exporter. So here importer may supply some of the expenses to the exporter. So this expense is also taken here, added here. So because here importer will be supplying some of the accessories or material to the exporter. Because reason is, if a importer wants to design his product as per his requirements, then the importer will send the accessories or materials to the exporter, which is in connection with the machine or for any import. So that should be added here because that is also taken as a expenses of a exporter in connection with the goods. Then any royalties and license fees paid also taken under the exporter expenses. Handling charges paid for the loading in the ship. So any handling charges here, loading in the ship means here loading comes here. So to load the goods into ship, any handling charges, if there is a handling charges incurred, then we have to add. Then design and development charges paid outside country. The design and development charges paid outside the country here. Expenses incurred here outside the country. Then any advance payment also makes here, advance payment also. Then share in the subsequent resale or freight from a supplier factory to port. Freight or any transportation expenses from a supplier factory, exporter factory to the port we have to add. Okay, so these expenses we have to add before FOB. So these are the expenses. If you add these expenses, we will get the free on board value of goods. So these expenses should be incurred by the exporter. So should be added before FOB. Okay. So these expenses should be incurred by the exporter place and should be added before FOB. Next, we have to add freight and transportation cost. Yeah. If in the illustration, if they give the transportation of freight or a transportation of the goods is by air, then we have to take the actual value or we have to compare with the 20% of this FOB value, whichever is less we have to take. And if that transportation is by ship or a sea, then if the value of transportation is given, then we have to take the actual value. If they don't give the transportation expenses amount, then we have to take 20% of FOB. So that is what. Then we have to add one more expenses, that is insurance. So if insurance expense is given, then we have to take the actual value as it is. If they don't give insurance expenses, then we have to calculate 1.125% of FOB. On this value we have to calculate. So after calculating, we will get the CIF, or assessable value of a goods. Cost, insurance and freight it is. So cost is nothing but, this is a cost, insurance and the freight expenses means the freight or a transportation expenses if it is by air or ship. So these are the expenses which is added after FOB is nothing but here. Expenses added after FOB means from a port to port. So whatever the expenses incurs from a exporter port to the importer port should be added after FOB. So after FOB we have to add the expenses, like it might be a air transportation by air or transportation by ship, or for the transportation they might take a insurance also, that is also expenses. So whatever the expenses incurs here should be added here after FOB. So that is what we have to take. So we will get assessable value here. So after the import of a goods from a other country, here the custom duty will be paid. So on this value we have to calculate the custom duty, but here we should not include the expenses which is incurred from an Indian port to importer place. Okay, from here if any expenses incurred, we should not add. So this is about the assessable value. On this assessable value we have to calculate the custom duty payable. So here there are two terms I have given, local agent commission and buying commission. This is one of a confusing point. There are two kinds of commission. Only local agent commission we have to add. Buying commission we should not take for this solution. Okay, so local agent commission means here exporter from abroad. So exporter from abroad appoints agent in India. So the exporter from abroad appoints agents in India to promote their sales in India, to promote exporter sales, their business sales in India. So that is a exporter from abroad appoints agent in India to promote their sale in India. These agents gets commission in Indian rupee, which is directly paid by the Indian importer. So his agents are staying in India. So for this agent, the Indian importer will pay the commission. So when Indian importer pay the commission means it will be in the form of Indian rupee. So this agent will get a commission in the form of Indian rupee, which is directly paid by the Indian importer. So he is nothing but the local agent. So local agent means who? He is the exporter's agent staying in India, and he will be promoting the exporter sales in India. So for that commission will be paid by the importer. So he is a exporter's agent, on behalf of a exporter commission will be paid. So actually it is expenses, the commission which is paid to a local agent by the importer is actually the exporter's expenses. It is paid on behalf of the exporter by the importer. So we have to treat that expense as a expenses incurred here. It is exporter's expense, should be added before FOB. Next, in the case of buying commission, it is paid by the importer. Buying commission also paid by the importer to his agent for the services representing him in abroad in purchase of goods being valued. So that is a buying commission means here the one agent will be there, that is a importer's agent. So who will be helping the importer? So importer agent or a buying commission buying agent or a importer agent will be staying outside India, and he will help the importer for the representing him in abroad in purchase of goods being valued. For as a importer, he will be representing as a importer in the abroad for his deal in the business. For the importing deal, he will be acting as a importer's agent, and for that he will be getting a commission. So that is nothing but buying commission. So that buying commission actually the importer's expenses. So that should not be added here. So we have to accept the buying commission because these are the expenses which is incurred by the exporter. Understood. So this is about the computing the format for determining the assessable value of goods. So remember, for the purchase price of goods, we have to add some of the expenses. So before FOB, we have to add some of the expenses which is incurred at a exporter, by the exporter or at a exporter place, and the sum of the expenses which is incurred after FOB is during the from port to port. So this is expenses incurred from a port to port, right here, port to port. So this port to port means from a from a exporter port to Indian port. So these are the expenses should be taken. So whatever the expenses incurs should be added after FOB. So whatever the expenses incurs after the import of a goods, after paying the custom duty, should not be included for computing the assessable value. So this is about the assessable value computation, very important for the 16 marks illustration relating to this format. Computation of assessable value and custom duty payable is very important for the section C.